Okay, so I recently watched an interesting but long video by Liv Boeree and Daniel Schmachtenberger, in which they discuss the idea that Moloch, the emergent dangers of multipolar traps, might be the most significant driving dynamic that means that companies and countries will continue to race towards human-level artificial general intelligence, or AGI, despite the known risks, including the risk that this might lead on to there then being a superintelligence that could dominate humanity. In this video, I'm going to use this insight to suggest a way that we actually could regulate further development in artificial intelligence, at least in a way that should delay this kind of existential risk of AI. But to get there, I'm first going to briefly explain what people mean by Moloch-style multipolar traps. Then, how a so-called intelligence explosion could lead to a misaligned superintelligence. And finally, I'll put these all together to explain the AI regulation that I think could at least delay the most dangerous outcomes. So many of you watching will have heard of the way that scenarios like tragedies of the commons or arms races have been analyzed within a branch of mathematics called game theory. So I'll keep this part brief. The classic example of game theory is the so-called payoff matrix of the prisoner's dilemma. The scenario is that, say, Adam and Bob are suspected of committing a serious crime and are facing 10 years in jail if convicted. But the cops only have enough information to convict them on a lesser crime, and so Adam and Bob are being interrogated in separate rooms to try to get a confession. If both Adam and Bob stay silent, then they'll both get 2 years in jail for the lesser crime. But the police really want to convict someone for the serious crime, so they offer a deal to Adam that if he confesses to the serious crime and thereby betrays Bob, and Bob stays silent, then Bob will serve the full 10 years and Adam will be set free. They offer the same deal to Bob too. But if both Adam and Bob confess, then they'll be jointly convicted and share the jail time, so they'll each serve 5 years. Now, between the two of them, the total jail time would be minimized to 4 years if they both stayed silent. But individually, both Adam and Bob realize that whatever their accomplice does, their most rational option is always to confess. So they both confess and each end up in jail for 5 years. So this is a classic example where the individual incentives are at odds with the group's best outcome, a group of two in this case. If you scale this kind of scenario up to large numbers of people, you get what is called a multipolar trap, like the tragedy of the commons, or multiple countries engaged in arms races. These scenarios are also talked about as being a failure of coordination, because if through regulation or cultural convention, you could get all the individuals to coordinate their behavior in line with the overall group goal, then the best outcome for the group overall could be achieved. Now, it's really frustrating that we regularly see this kind of coordination failure undermine our shared society-level goals in so many places. And that has led some people to start referring to this emergent, damaging multipolar trap phenomenon as if it were an ancient god or demon always tempting us towards these bad outcomes. And it was Scott Alexander who, inspired by a Ginsberg poem, first suggested naming this demon as being the ancient pagan deity Moloch in his blog post from 2014. And this seems to have caught on. For example, as well as Liv Boeree and Daniel Schmachtenberger using the term, Max Tegmark was also referring to Moloch in his latest appearance on the Lex Fridman podcast.
Have you read Meditations on Moloch by Scott Alexander? It's this game theory monster that pits people into against each other in this race to the bottom where everybody ultimately loses. The evil thing about this monster is, even though everybody sees it and understands, they still can't get out of the race, right?
So what about the relation between Molochian-style dynamics and artificial intelligence? So a few months ago, there was an open letter suggesting a 6-month pause on AI development to allow the work on AI safety and regulation to catch up with the ever-accelerating pace of AI improvements. That letter has now been signed by well over 30,000 people, including Stuart Russell and Elon Musk, and many others with deep knowledge of the state of the art of AI technology. I mention this because it demonstrates the widespread concern that even people working actively in the field of AI have about the pace at which AI development is happening. The uncharitable reading of this letter is that it has thousands of signatories who are saying society should slow down AI progress, when individually they're speeding it up, because they feel rationally compelled to do so, because developing the best AI will give you such an obvious competitive advantage. The letter simply highlights the existence of a classic multipolar trap, and as Daniel Schmachtenberger points out, these Molochian dynamics aren't coming from AI itself, but from the capitalist and geopolitical context in which we are developing AI.
That set of perverse incentives and the coordinations that arise from it is misaligned. Alignment in that thing has to be figured out, because a misaligned context cannot develop aligned AI.
But how serious are the dangers of this Molochian trap? Of course, the most imminent, most definite risks from AI are not the existential risks of a superintelligence wiping out humanity, but rather that the accelerating progress of AI will simply supercharge the existing dangers to society of algorithmic automation, such as the embedding of inequalities and prejudice into algorithms that govern so much of our lives, and the creation of fake social media content distorting our public discourse, and the inability of society to meaningfully reconfigure our political economy as more and more jobs get automated. But these aren't the dangers that those in the field of AI are most worried about. What they're most worried about is the idea of an intelligence explosion. This is the sci-fi sounding process whereby we develop an artificial general intelligence, an AGI, with potentially above human level ability to understand how their own algorithm works and be smart enough to devise a way to build a better algorithm. They can self-improve themselves. And then those even smarter AIs could self-improve their design even further, and so on, in an accelerating loop of improvement that has long been referred to as an intelligence explosion. The upshot of this process of self-improvement would be a superintelligent AI that has been designed by AIs and is so vastly superior to humans that we are unlikely to understand how it works or what it really thinks. It would be like having super-advanced aliens living among us. The fear is that because such superintelligent AIs could easily outsmart us, so they could choose to dominate us or even eliminate all of humanity if they wanted to. But let's take this back to our multipolar trap scenario around AI development today. And so, obviously, the real society-level goal is not just a six-month pause, but that we should be attempting to avoid or at least delay the intelligence explosion for as long as possible. But given the amazing potential benefits of advanced AI, it's as if Moloch has devised the ultimate temptation that could destroy humanity. And there are some voices, including Sam Altman from OpenAI, who seem to be arguing that we should keep working towards building superintelligent AIs. In a recent blog post with Greg Brockman and Ilya Sutskever, they said that we should continue down this path for two reasons. First, we believe it's going to lead to a much better world than what we can imagine today. Yeah, it's really tempting to build it. Second, we believe it would be unintuitively risky and difficult to stop the creation of superintelligence. In other words, it's really hard to stop it. So let's just accept that we're going to build it and try and do our best. Now, in another video about superintelligence, I've talked about the dangers of actively questing after such awesome powers in the belief that we'll be able to control it. But here I want to focus on a suggestion for how I think we can actually delay the intelligence explosion. An idea that, as far as I can tell, most discussions on this topic are overlooking. an idea that does not suffer from a Molochian multipolar trap. So the idea is based on extending the analogy of this process being an intelligence explosion. A real explosion requires multiple ingredients to happen: the explosive, oxygen, and a spark to ignite it. If we hold back the spark of ignition, nothing happens. In the case of the intelligence explosion, I think the spark is the ability of the AI to autonomously self-improve itself in an open-ended way. This is the ability that would enable an AI to rapidly improve itself beyond our understanding of how it's working and what it's capable of. And I actually think Moloch will let us hold back this spark. If we go back to our diagram of the multipolar trap, we can separate out the society-level goal into, very roughly, two distinct goals. The first is the goal to avoid the existential risk of superintelligence. The second is to avoid all of the other dangers to societies from AI. Similarly, let's split the individual-level incentives into two. Firstly, there's the incentive to build AIs that have the spark, that have the ability to autonomously self-improve themselves in an open-ended way, an ability that I've been calling meta-level agency. And secondly, there's the incentive to build an AI that's better at performing a particular task, or indeed, better at a general class of tasks. Now, from what I can see, open-ended self-improvement is simply not a feature that any corporation building a product is going to want in their product. OpenAI wouldn't want ChatGPT to upgrade itself and then decide that it actually isn't interested in answering any more questions. It now just wants to use its plugins to interact with other parts of the internet by itself. Nor would Tesla want its self-driving cars to become curious to explore the world rather than simply drive to the requested destination. Meta-level agency, where an AI system can improve itself in an open-ended way, could allow an AI to upgrade its high-level goals. After all, that is what humans can do when they, I don't know, give up all their worldly possessions and go and live the life of a Buddhist monk. The outcomes of open-ended self-improvement are inherently unpredictable. So, this necessary spark for the intelligence explosion is not actually something that individual companies, or indeed militaries, or authoritarian regimes are going to want in their AI systems. That's why I think that for this feature, the incentives of the individuals align with the incentives of society as a whole, even when considering the most self-serving, powerful bad actors. Well, at least the ones that are acting rationally with respect to their own interests. Now, okay, there will also be irrational bad actors who will be tempted to build such things just to unleash chaos on the world and damn the consequences. Indeed, we've already seen people joking around with application names like Chaos GPT. But with more advanced AI, this kind of pranking around could become much more serious. So this is why we shouldn't just rely on the self-interest of rational actors to self-regulate the avoidance of meta-level agency. We should treat the creation of AIs with open-ended abilities to autonomously self-improve themselves at least as seriously as we ought to be regulating things like gain-of-function research into pathogens. It may be scientifically interesting to do it, but it's extremely dangerous. Now, admittedly, just because the individual and societal interests of this feature line up, that doesn't mean that there aren't still plenty of Molochian-style dynamics for other aspects of AI that are also very dangerous for society, even if they're not existential threats. And I intend to make other videos about these more immediate dangers and impacts of AI on our political economies. But I hope that I've given here some good reasons to believe that, from a game theory-style perspective, it should be possible to get global regulation to prevent the creation of AIs with meta-level agency, and thereby to at least delay the intelligence explosion until we know more about what we're doing. And in my next video, I'm going to go into more depth about what I mean by meta-level agency, including a rough sketch of how regulating it could work. But what do you think about this proposal? Or do you think it's hopeless trying to slow down the progress of AI? Please do continue the conversation in the comments below, and subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching.